It's Free Radio, your travel on the way very soon, all the ladies to get you home. But tonight, talking about how you met your other half.
I was talking to somebody over the weekend how he met his other half because it was his nan's
Shropolist. How did you meet your other half? Sue, in London, you were involved in a car accident, Sue.
I met him when I was at some traffic light, and the next thing I know, this guy rams into my car.
So I get out, right, ready to have just the biggest go at him, and then I see him. I mean, he had like a John Travolta chin, you know? So I kind of sort of swept it under the rug, really, that he knocked into me. And then, you know, here we are still all these years later.
Sounds like a right charmer, Sue.
Thanks for your call. We've also got Carl, who's in Coventry, whose wife saved him from the rain. What happened, Carl?
Well, it was raining and I was walking to the car after work. I had no coat and
this girl came up to me and asked me if I wanted to walk under her umbrella. But the umbrella, it was blown inside out by the wind. And by the time we reached the car,
we were both soaked. Now we've been married over 46 years and I've never left the house without an umbrella since.
Well, you wouldn't, because otherwise you'd forget her and probably end up running off somebody else's car.
Actually, she forgets who I am. There's just this look on her face. Like she doesn't understand.
Oh, small things at first. No, I didn't put them together.
Well, it was about 2 years before she was diagnosed. A lot of times it's a simple thing, like if I need a haircut or something, I can't just leave her on her own. She'll wander off. We went walking with a dog last week and her mood just changed and she ran off.
Because I had the dog with me, I couldn't keep up. When I got home, I called the police and explained that she'd got dementia, that she'd run off, and thankfully an hour later, they brought her home.
Sometimes she's nothing like the person she used to be. And suddenly she'll say something. She'll respond to something like she used to. Like she never
forgets to remind me to take an umbrella with me if I'm going out. Oh, and she always laughs when her favourite programme is on TV. She has a sense of humour. She's still there, still is the same person.
But she just isn't. And I find myself not hating,
but resentful toward her. This is someone I married, I love, that I had children with, and I'm resenting her because she's ruining my life, and then
I feel guilty. But it must be so upsetting for her, because she knows what's going on, but she can't stop. I love her. I've never stopped telling her that. You never know what's around the corner or when it'll end.
Sorry, sometimes we seem to have lost Carl there. He's very lucky to have his wife and she's lucky to have him. Going to get some more of your calls very soon, and your most accurate travel is on the way next.
At me, I was looking at you. We didn't say much, but well, both of us knew.
We knew because we couldn't help but simply smile.
Thank you for watching. What you have just seen was written using the actual words and experiences of just a few of those suffering from dementia and of those who care for them. There are millions of people worldwide affected by this condition, and the impact on them and their families can be devastating. I hope you can help.
So take me along, take me for a ride, 'cause when we're together, I'm alive inside. And by all the things you do, your love always shines through. Yeah, all I ever want is you.